Prepare for the unknown by studying how others in the past have coped with the unforeseeable. Good morning, today is Monday, December 25, 2023. Today in history, on this day 46 years ago, the renowned British comedy film artist Charlie Chaplin passed away. Notable for works like The Circus, The Great Dictator, Modern Times, and City Lights, he excelled in using comedy to depict the essence of real-life tragedy. With multiple Academy Awards to his name, Chaplin is celebrated as one of the world's most famous and significant actors, recognized as one of the greatest artists in film history. Qing Qiao, bridging the business world and delivering information to you. Welcome to today's Qing Qiao Morning News. Let's start with political updates. Indonesia detects suspicious election-related funds. In recent comprehensive news from Jakarta, the Indonesian Financial Transaction Reports and Analysis Center revealed that authorities discovered certain special accounts designated for campaign funds showed a prolonged absence of significant fund flows. However, transactions with other accounts of candidates and related individuals persisted, with a notable surge in the number of transactions over the past 3 months. Ivan Yestiavandana, the head of the Indonesian Financial Transaction Reporting and Analysis Center, emphasized that typically, as elections approach, bank accounts officially designated for campaigns should witness increased activity, serving as the primary source of funds for candidates and the government's election-related initiatives. The current unusual state of these accounts raises suspicions, leading authorities to believe there may be illicit transfers in the upcoming election. Reportedly, one of the bank accounts flagged with numerous suspicious transactions belongs to an Indonesian political party participating in the election, involving transactions totaling hundreds of billions of rupiah. Local media sources indicate that these funds are allegedly derived from illegal activities like illicit mining and short-term corporate loans. The Indonesian Financial Transaction Reports and Analysis Center has officially notified the General Elections Commission and the General Elections Supervisory Agency about these findings. President Joko Widodo has directed law enforcement agencies to pursue the case. However, Rahmat Bagja, the chairman of the Indonesian General Elections Supervisory Agency, clarified that the commission oversees cases related to campaign fund violations, and matters concerning political party funds fall outside its supervision. Vietnam continues to fight corruption. In recent comprehensive news from Hanoi, the Vietnamese government website released a statement noting that the Central Inspection Commission of the Central Committee of the Communist Party of Vietnam has identified serious violations in its investigation of the Ministry of Industry and Trade, MOIT. The committee recommended disciplinary sanctions against implicated officials, including former Deputy Prime Minister Trinh Dinh Duong, Politburo members, former MOIT Minister Tran Tuan An, Deputy MOIT Minister Du Thanh Hai, and Secretary of the Party Committee and Chairman of Vietnam Oil and Gas Group, Hong Quoc Phong. The statement indicated that these identified violations were associated with the planning and regulatory development mechanisms of solar and wind power policies. These actions were deemed to have resulted in serious consequences that are challenging to address, leading to substantial financial and asset losses for the country. Reportedly, the Vietnamese government has intensified anti-corruption efforts in 2021. Over 1,300 corruption cases have been investigated, leading to prosecutions of more than 3,500 individuals. Several high-ranking officials, including former President Nguyen Xuân Phúc and two former deputy prime ministers, Pham Binh Minh and Vu Duc Dam, have been compelled to step down amid these anti-corruption measures. Secondly, we'll bring you updates on military-related news. South Korea set to revise military service standards. As per Lianhe Zaobao News, the South Korean Ministry of National Defense plans to amend the standards for distinguishing military service positions, specifically by increasing the body mass index, the threshold for alternative service positions. Those opting for alternative service can serve in government agencies instead of military units. BMI is calculated by dividing weight by height squared. Currently, the Korean Army's recruitment targets for alternative service include men with a BMI below 16 and above 35. The proposed amendment seeks to adjust this standard to a BMI below 15 and above 40. For instance, a 1.74-meter male, originally eligible for alternative service with a weight over 106 kilograms, would require a weight of 121.2 kilograms after the amendment. Speculation suggests that this revision aims to increase military recruitment by 6,000 to 7,000 individuals annually in South Korea. The South Korean Ministry of National Defense raised the alternative service threshold due to a declining population, putting military service resources in a state of emergency. According to the South Korean Military Manpower Administration, intentionally gaining or losing weight ranks as one of the traditional methods of evading military service, claiming the top spot among various types of military service evasion. Myanmar accused of violating international laws of war in ongoing conflict. On December 21, Amnesty International stated that the Myanmar military government is suspected of carrying out indiscriminate attacks on civilians and using banned cluster munitions in its crackdown on ethnic minority armed groups. Amnesty International called for an investigation into potential war crimes. Human Rights Watch accused the Myanmar National Democratic Alliance Army of violating international laws of war by kidnapping and forcibly recruiting fleeing civilians in Shan State. Previously, through China's mediation and facilitation, the Myanmar military engaged in peace talks with the Kokong, Tong, and Arakan Army in China. Subsequently, an agreement was reached on issues including a temporary ceasefire and the continuation of dialogue. However, in the past week, clashes between government forces and local armed forces persist. The Tong Army declared control over Namsan, a trading town in Shan State. The military government directed airstrikes on Arakan Army strongholds and initiated shelling from the sea. Now, let's turn our attention to the latest economic news. Malaysia tops Southeast Asia in inbound tourist numbers this year. According to reports from Kuala Lumpur, data released by Jakarta-based online media Sisia reveals that from January to November this year, Malaysia led Southeast Asian countries in receiving the most foreign tourists. Thailand, traditionally a tourist powerhouse, ranked second with 24.6 million visitors, followed by Singapore with 11.3 million visitors, and Vietnam with 11.2 million visitors. Malaysia's inbound tourist numbers have returned to pre-pandemic levels. As of November 15 this year, statistics from the Malaysian Immigration Bureau indicate that among the approximately 26 million foreign tourists entering Malaysia, those from Singapore comprised the largest group, totaling 12.64 million. Following this, Indonesia and Thailand had 3.16 million and 2.07 million tourists, respectively, with China ranking fourth at 1.4 million visitors. Reportedly, a significant factor contributing to the sharp increase in Malaysia's tourism industry is its focus on the substantial Chinese market. Starting at the end of March this year, Tourism Malaysia intensified efforts to attract Chinese tourists. Apart from promoting Malaysian tourist attractions in major Chinese cities, the campaign included digital media promotions, special travel product promotions, and initiatives promoting food, sports, and fashion culture. Now, here is some important safety information. Thai troops eliminate 15 drug traffickers on northern Thailand-Myanmar border. News from Bangkok reports that the Thai military recently disclosed an intense encounter in Mae Phahluang District, Chiang Rai Province. While patrolling the border garrison, the military discovered over 10 individuals engaged in drug smuggling in the Golden Triangle area spanning Thailand, Myanmar, and Laos. Upon interception, the suspects opened fire, leading to a 5-minute gun battle. The Thai army successfully neutralized 15 drug trafficking suspects in what is considered the most intense confrontation with drug gangs in recent years. A military spokesperson mentioned that they confiscated over 2 million methamphetamine pills, colloquially known as meth, from 17 backpacks left by the suspects. Northern Thailand, with a border of over 500 kilometers with Myanmar, serves as a primary conduit for drugs from the Golden Triangle to enter Thailand. The provinces of Chiang Rai, Chiang Mai, Mae Hong Son, and others witness a significant influx of drugs, constituting a substantial portion of the overall drug trade in Thailand. Finally, here's some intriguing cultural news. Cambodia-China University of Technology and Science inaugurated in Phnom Penh. According to ASEAN Financial News, the Nanjing Vocational University of Industry Technology, China's first public undergraduate vocational school, and Cambodia's largest overseas Chinese association, the Federation of Khmer Chinese in Cambodia, have collaboratively established the Cambodian-China University of Technology and Science in Phnom Penh, Cambodia's capital. This marks a significant stride in the cultural exchanges and educational cooperation between China and Cambodia, with each country appointing an executive principal for the university. The Cambodia-China University of Technology and Science, situated in Khoi Chang Var District, Phnom Penh, spans 75 acres. It specializes in undergraduate degree education, offering programs in new energy power generation technology, automotive service engineering technology, network engineering technology, e-commerce, modern logistics management, and tourism management. The university employs various models, including 4+0, 2+2, 3+1, for vocational undergraduate degree training. Qualified students have the opportunity to obtain academic qualifications and degree certificates from both China and Cambodia. Financial newsletter. According to the Thailand Press, the price of light crude oil futures for delivery in February 2024 on the New York Mercantile Exchange recently dropped by 33 cents, closing at $73.89 per barrel, reflecting a 0.44% decrease. Similarly, London Brent crude oil futures for February 2024 delivery saw a decrease of 31 cents, closing at $79.39 per barrel, down by 0.39%. That's all for today's Tsim Sha Morning News. Thank you for listening.